There's progress at the old Madison Mines in Fredericktown, dormant since the late 70s when they stopped mining lead. But what looks like mud and was left behind is highly valuable. It's cobalt. This concentrate of cobalt, nickel, and copper is sought after. Missouri has a motherload of it, and Missouri Cobalt is a few weeks away from producing at maximum capacity to the international market.
We have the largest near-term primary cobalt reserve in North America, and that's not going anywhere.
Technology is fueling the growing demand for cobalt. Lithium-ion batteries run on cobalt, which powers cell phones, laptops, and the batteries in electric cars. There is a worldwide demand for cobalt.
2 years ago, we had 17 global battery makers. Now there are 72 battery makers, gigafactories, which need the very critical components of nickel and cobalt, both which we have here, for their production.
Stacy Hasty, owner and chairman of Missouri Cobalt, told us last year that his company is on a mission to provide clean, green, ethically produced battery materials for the renewable energy industry. They are also cleaning the area and eliminating any possible environmental problems. Plus, they have added 33 brand new jobs so far.
The jobs will go from 33 where they are now to over 250, and with ancillary work and contracting, it'll be 600 to 1,000 jobs we're going to bring to Southeast Missouri.
Missouri Cobalt is producing from surface ore left behind from the mines. They are selling to smelters. It's big business, and when they go subsurface, they will be a one-stop shop for the world.
We are definitely in contact with some of the world's biggest buyers of cobalt, including Tesla.
Experts see a tripling of demand by 2025, and with no other new supply other than what's called conflict cobalt in the Congo because of child labor, Missouri Cobalt is well positioned to supply on their 1,800 acres.
Vic Faust, Fox 2 News.